Hi, I'm Paul Kaiser. Let's talk about the difference between bitmap and vector graphics. Bitmap graphics are kind of like working with a large piece of graph paper. Here we are. We've got all these different squares. They're all the same size, lined up in rows and columns. And each one of these is called a pixel. Well, each one can have its own color. When we do that, color each one individually, we can end up with a nice image. This is working with bitmap graphics. Vector graphics don't use pixels, instead they use paths. This line you see here that I'm tracing, this is a path. And so what we do with vector graphics is define those paths which go between points. So we have points, and between them we have paths. And we define how those paths are shaped between points with these tool handles here. Behind the scenes, the program is keeping track of this with a mathematical equation, and that's what's stored for our vector graphics. So we're not talking about pixels, we're just talking about paths and the shape of the path. An important difference between bitmap and vector graphics is how they're stored and their resulting file size. We said that in bitmap graphics there are all these pixels. Well, bitmap graphic generally stores the number of pixels wide in the image, number of pixels tall in the image, and then it has to store a color value for each and every pixel in the image. That can result in a lot of information and a pretty good size file. For vector images, the files are stored completely different. All that's saved generally is information about each point, where it's at in relation to other points, and then information about the path between points. How long are these handles? Which direction are they pointing? And that's about it. As a result, vector graphics can be pretty small files. Bitmap files and vector files are usually saved in different types of files. Your bitmap most common file formats are BMP, your GIF, your JPEG, your PNG, and your TIFF. Those are generally your most common bitmap file types. For vector graphics, your most common types are usually AI, which is Illustrator format, EPS, and SVG. There are other types out there, there are plenty, but these are the three most common ones you're going to find today. We can't talk about bitmap and vector graphics without talking about resolution and detail. In bitmap graphics, the resolution refers to how much detail is in the image and directly affects the quality of the output. So here I have a low resolution image, and you can see there's not much detail, there are a lot of little jaggy edges, that sort of thing. So this is a lower resolution and it's not going to print very well. Here's a higher resolution version of the same shot. As you see here, I've got a lot more detail, a lot crisper edges, that sort of thing, and this is going to print great. When we talk about detail, this is like the difference between a 5 megapixel digital camera shot and a 1 megapixel digital camera shot. The lower megapixel is less detail. You're going to be able to do less with that image. With the higher detail image, we can take that detail and spread it over a larger area. We could print perhaps a large poster out of this image, whereas the other lower resolution image, we might be able to print a postage stamp, and that's about it. A lot of times when people are asked to provide a higher resolution image, they make the mistake of thinking they can do that by making a simple change in their image editing program. They'll go in here and say, well, I'll just change the resolution up to 600. I'll just double it and it'll be great. Well, the problem with that is you didn't actually capture any more detail. When you made that resolution higher, the program just worked with the detail it had, made some average calculations, and added some more pixels around it. As you can see, it's still fuzzy. There's not really any more detail captured. So if you need more detail, you have to actually go out and retake your digital camera photo at a higher resolution, or you need to put your photograph maybe on your desktop computer scanner and scan it again at a higher resolution. Well, what about vector graphics when we're talking about detail here? We said that vector graphics were not dependent on pixels. It's dependent on these paths instead. Well, check it out. I can zoom in, increasing the size of this image a ridiculous amount, and I'm not really losing any detail around this edge. What happens is this mathematical curve is recalculated every time I size it up or down. The only limitation when it comes to detail with a vector graphic is the output device. In this case, when we're doing this screencast, our output device is a computer monitor, but your output device could also be a 300 dpi laser printer, 300 dots per inch. That's not really that high a resolution. Or it could be a 1200 dots per inch laser printer, a lot more detail there. Or it could be a 2500 dot per inch film setter for printing a coffee table book or something really high quality. So this same graphic, this same vector graphic could be output on all those devices, and the higher performing device is going to make use of all of its pixels to give us a nice smooth curve. Well, we've really made it sound like vector graphics are the way to go with their small file size and their fact that you're not limited with detail, but let's have a look at a nice bitmap image here in Photoshop. This is an image of a wedding dress. It has a lot of detail in here and a lot of subtle tone variation on the skin, that sort of thing. Now, because it's a bitmap graphic, we can set the color of each individual pixel independently and get this nice, smooth, continuous tone. Well, we can't really do that with a vector graphic. Remember, vector graphics are built of paths, and each path can have a color and it can have a fill on the inside. But here's what it looks like when we try to make that same wedding dress in Illustrator. Now, you might be looking for this stylized effect, but if you really want a photograph, vector graphics are not the way to go. Well, what's a good use for vector graphics then? Well, look at these logos. These logos might be used on business cards or they might be used on billboards. Remember, we talked about vector graphics not really having limitations on the detail based on the size. So you could take the same little logo here, put it on a little business card, then blow it up and put it on a billboard and not lose any detail from the vector graphic. As you're learning to work with graphics, if you just stick to bitmap images for your photographs and then use vector graphics for your logos, that sort of artwork, you'll be just fine. I hope you've enjoyed this little introduction, and I hope that you'll see more tutorials in the near future about working specifically with bitmap graphics and working specifically with vector graphics.